Hello everyone, I'm Santiago Santiago, and today I'm gonna be testing Borderlands 2 on the GeForce GTX 1050 Ti. For FPS monitoring, I'll be using Cam. If you want to download this software, there's a link down in the description. And if you enjoy the content and want to support the channel directly, there's a link to the Patreon page down in the description as well. So Borderlands 2, I'll be doing 1080p, 1440p and 4K. To skip any of those sections of the video, check the description below. So first I'll show you 1080p without physics, and then I'll show you one of the areas where I found big FPS drops and how to make it run better in those cases. Then I will just enable physics and run the same areas so you can see what the difference in performance is. Then I'll do the same on 1440p and 4K. I'll show you the ideal settings, and then I'll turn on NVIDIA physics. You'll see that I will lower the view distance from the highest to medium. By doing that, the frame rate goes up much higher, sometimes from 45 to 65, and you'll also see that the GPU usage is low. Lowering the view distance also helps in increasing that as well. I tried better CPUs and it barely made a difference. It just seems that the game won't take advantage of more than 2 cores so far. So what I would recommend first is to lower the draw distance to medium or low if you want to increase your frame rate in places where the frame rate drops without a reason. Usually big maps where you can see very far away places, it happens, but it can vary quite a bit. I tried some other places where people told me that the game ran the worst, like the first snow level full of bandits, or the Washburn refinery, and other places, but I didn't experience as low frame rates as I show you here at the start of the footage. So this configuration should apply for a big part of the game. NVIDIA PhysX ran terribly bad, it just seems to be not properly optimized on this game. A lot of people claim that Borderlands the pre-sequel doesn't have the problem with those NVIDIA effects, so keep that in mind. And if you keep those NVIDIA effects on low, it means that the effect is disabled. The performance difference between high and medium in that case is very small, at least on my end. So I just recommend to keep the NVIDIA features on low, which means turn off, and the draw distance on medium or low if you want to be at 60 frames per second or over as much as possible. Lowering the resolution to 900p or 720p doesn't make a difference at all compared to 1080p on the places where you have a lot of stuff going on and you drop to 60 or below that target. Same happens if you have the NVIDIA effects enabled, so don't expect any improvement in that case. In this game, those NVIDIA effects just seem to be unoptimized and it doesn't seem to take advantage of more cores, so this is the best I could do with this game so far. Anyway guys, that's pretty much it. I hope you keep enjoying the video, thanks for watching, and see you next time.
Now known to me. Time to go to work.
This is going to hurt! Power!